Welcome to another episode of the Basecamp from Ascend Inbound Marketing. I'm Anne Shenton, the agency director, and I have with me Gretchen Elliott, project manager. Today we are going to talk about content strategy. You know, what is content strategy? How can you use content strategy in your business? What are some do's and don'ts of content strategy? You know, just a good little primer on content strategy today. So I think I've said content strategy enough times now. We can dive right in. First of all, just a quick overview. You know, I think this term gets tossed around a lot. You know, you need a content strategy. Content is king, blah, blah, blah. But we really want to kind of get back to the basics and define what content strategy is. So, Gretchen, I don't know if you have some thoughts on that. I have some thoughts, but getting back to the
basics. I think you're on a roll.
Okay.
You just keep going.
I'll keep going. So, content strategy is really just the discipline of using content to meet your business objectives. And that sounds kind of fancy, but really, if we break it down, it can be as simple as answering frequently asked questions that your customers are constantly calling in to ask you, just so you know, you don't have to continually answer the same question over and over again through phone calls. That's a really simple example of content strategy. Of course, it can get a lot more complex than that, but just as an example there, that's one way it can work.
But I think you did bring up a good point there, is that content strategy can look, can function in a lot of different ways for a lot of different businesses or companies, but still achieve the goals that you're looking for.
Right.
So it doesn't have to be some like big, scary, you know, oh, I've got to make some big slide deck with this like content strategy in it. It can just be what's easy for your business to do.
Right.
That's going to bring in more customers.
Mm-hmm. Yep, and that is a good point, Gretchen. Another big component of content strategy that kind of ties in hand with a lot of the content strategy that we develop for our partners is the idea of SEO or search engine optimization, and developing content that is going to drive more and more traffic to your website, and not just any traffic, right, but qualified traffic from people who you actually want to do business with, you know, answering questions that they have about working with companies like you, providing, you know, how-to guides and again, frequently asked questions and things like that, that will help them along in their buyer's journey as they evaluate different organizations to work with. That's just, you know, one piece of that. But again, it can be a lot of different things. Things as simple as frequently asked questions to a full-blown SEO strategy. You know, all of those are kind of encompassed under the umbrella of content strategy.
Yeah. I think another thing too that, you know, maybe this is the kind of the next phase of your content strategy is you can really use it to help streamline some of your processes.
Mm-hmm.
So Anne brought up frequently asked questions, which again is just one we go back to because it's everyone can pretty much understand what that example is and probably think of some things in their business or company that they do get asked a lot and they know that potential customers, you know, leads are interested in. But maybe think of things that come up even later in your buyer's journey. You know, questions that you're answering or problems customers might encounter. Or maybe they say like, well, I see, you know, these other competitors or companies, you know, talking about X topic and you all aren't necessarily talking about that. There's opportunity to create some content around those topics as well.
Yeah. And I guess just to drive it home a little bit, I want to leave everybody with an example of actual content strategy in action, because I think it becomes more real when you know a story that, you know, how we actually have used this and how it might work. So one of our clients, Orson Woodall of Woodall & Woodall, is a bankruptcy attorney. And he has generated a lot of organic search traffic from qualified visitors because what he has been able to do with our partnership with him is answer a lot of the questions that his prospective clients have surrounding, you know, financial burden and which type of bankruptcy they should apply for, you know, which type of bankruptcy are they the best fit for, how to raise their credit score after they have filed filed for bankruptcy? What are the steps involved when filing for bankruptcy? You know, answering those full range of questions really educates his prospective clients. It eases their minds, so in turn establishes trust with them out of the gate, even before they get in touch with Orson to set that first appointment. And it has been very useful for Orson, you know, to obtain new clients, but then, you know, reduce client churn and things like that as well.
Mm-hmm. I think another example too, and you know, we work with SuperSod, mm-hmm. and when you're thinking about lawn care as a homeowner, you know, you want your lawn to look nice, but it's like, mm-hmm. How do you actually get
right.
there without yeah. having to spend a ton of time on it yourself? And I think that, you know, they, with our help, have done an excellent job of creating, you know, a lot of content mm-hmm. that appeals to homeowners, whether it's the type of grass for the area of the mm-hmm. southeast that you live in, yeah. How you take care of it, what does even the install process look like? Because maybe getting sod for the first time can seem like an overwhelming experience, but it really mm-hmm. isn't. So they're able to have some guides or create resources that can, you know, in turn ease their customers.
Yep, and in turn, they have built just a massive library of content. So really, any question that you have about lawn care and maintenance, you can find the answer to on supersod.com. And that really is a testament to the marketing team that they have there. Of course, we support that and help them out, but they are hell-bent on helping their customers, you know, with whatever lawn care needs they have and helping answer any questions that they have. So it is a really good example also. All right, well, I think that wraps it up for our little chat on content strategy. Thank you guys for watching. If you have any questions about this topic or want to get in touch, you can hit us up on chat or give us a call, and would love to meet you and get in touch. Thanks.